first, The African Religion, Volume 4. And I started off on verse, the mythology in the death and resurrection of Heru. And I read the 34th verse, at least the 32nd and the 34th verse in the mythology, where Osset was in prison and she escaped. And where she was fleeing from danger on the 34th verse, and she went to this house, and the woman slammed the door in her face. Well, this would be the fourth lecture on that verse. I started out in the first lecture. I tried to point out the weakness of the personality, how the woman act in slamming the door in Osset's face. And then I point out on the second lecture, spiritual character, the strength in the spiritual character, seeing how Osset act. She didn't react to the situation, but she learned how to act in the most proper way. She didn't act in a vengeful way, but she acted in a way of compassion, empathy, because it becomes a necessity to act the way, realizing that the woman act from a point of ignorance. And then, within there, the next lecture I did on it is to show, pointing out, we as a cultural group, where we find ourselves where the door is shut in our face. But while the door is shut in our face, we have a solution to overcome all obstacles. Now, one may dispute the authenticity of African religion, and one may have a problem in even practicing African religion because of the popularity and custom of other religion which we are brought up into. It becomes very difficult for us to totally, I would say, emerge ourselves into African religion without carrying the baggage of Western thoughts and ideas into that religion, so it causes confusions. And today, a lecture would be on the woman again. The lecture today on the woman is, what is the cause of the woman perceiving things in the way she perceives it? And first, I want to quote Lyra Brodowski, a professor of Stanford University. Quote, "The structure that exists in our language profoundly shapes how we construct reality and help make us as smart and sophisticated as we are." End of quote. And in the story, I mentioned where Set had already sent out a decree, because Set had killed Osar, and he becomes the ruler of the land. He had taken over the throne. So he rules Egypt at the time. he sent out a decree stating that anyone taking Oset and her son, he's going to kill them. So one, I would like to look at what this decree could really mean for us, not only individually, but from a collective point of view. As a quote from above, language and culture is very important. They are tied together. They cannot be separated. What does, it says, Seth sent out a decree that anyone takes in Oset and her son Hugh, they would be killed. What does it mean to us as a people collectively and individually? One, education. Seth sent out a decree. He educated the people to act in certain ways, to think and act like him. The woman follow and act according to the consciousness of the education she received. And I'm trying to answer a question amongst us as a collective group of people. We're always asking ourselves, what's wrong with us? Why we cannot assemble ourselves as a group of people without having confusion and fighting and killing one another? Well, we are in a society that educates us. We are in a Western society. That Western society has educated us. So what has happened? We have taken on all the habits, the values, everything from that Western society, we have taken that on. Through the language of the education that we've been taught. So in order to say, we are not thinking of ourselves, but we have been driven by the thoughts and ideas that are placed into the mind. So our mind is being captivated by Western values. And because it's been captivated by Western values, then we act like Westerners. We cannot see each other as related to each other. We see each other then as enemies, because we all get a piece of that Western teaching in different schools, different country, different places. So we end up fighting amongst ourselves. And I have good examples I can tell based upon my readings. There are many people come to this country here. When they come to this country, they use the education system in this country. But what they did when they go home was a different story. What they did when they go home, they learn how to teach their children their culture. And this African religion that we practice, Shweta Nitya, the Nitarian teaching, it is an African culture, and we who belongs to the lineage of an African people who holds close to that, who identify ourselves as that, must be able to follow that path in order to gain, quote unquote, your sense of liberation from the domination that you find yourself into. No one is going to do it for you. We can't pretend that racism doesn't exist anymore. And as I said the other day, we have become a people so enmeshed that when we have to send our children to school and send them out on the street, we write little books and papers and give them to keep in the pocket, that when people stop them on the street, they know what to say. Have you ever seen or read anybody on planet Earth have to do that? No one else on planet Earth have to do that, but you, who belongs to the African race, find yourself in such a position, yet you deny. You deny that there is anything that prevents you from manifesting the quality, from manifesting yourself as a person with values, as a such a human being, and you subject yourself to such a thoughts and ideas and believe everything is all right. You live in denial, and your denial causes your children to be in prison. Your daughter's been raped. Your children have no food. You, the woman, social worker, throw the husband out of the house. You cannot have food, get money from the government. They throw the husband out, they mash the family up. And then walk in and do what they want to do with you. Shut the door in your face. So the education you receive and believe to yourself that you're making advancement, I'm telling you, as a people, you are more sinking yourself into the state of oblation rather than going harder, because your culture, your language is not what you're using. You must have a vision in order to go forward. You cannot use someone else's vision in order to put yourself, quote unquote, in what you call your future. No, you're not going to get there. You must have your own vision, and you can only get there through your own vision, through your own labor, through your own culture, through your own language. No one in time and space has ever acquired anything without having their own language and their own culture. And that's where we find ourselves, these doors of set. Educating that woman. And this is what has happened to us. We have been educated to European. When in colonialism, one of the things that happened, the education, when you were stopped from having an education, when they realized, the slave master realized that it's important for him to progress, what he did, he said, I'm going to allow education, but what was his education? He gives you the Bible. He allowed the education of the Bible, so you only had what they call religious education, and it's one of the reasons we today pack up in the churches and we'd never let it go, because why? Those of the past never understood this tragedy, I would say. Very few that was played upon us, because we believe in God. We accept anything that comes down the line, and we find ourselves today crying out. We find ourselves today crying out. We cry, Christianity and good. This one is good, this one is good. Again, because of the standard, the type of education, we become the people who like what I like to call, we are in love with lectures and not in love with our people to help liberate us from the kind of domination that we find ourselves into. The doors are shut. Not as any spurge I'm throwing on Frederick Douglass, but cannot quote him quite clearly, but he had made a statement based upon the condition that African people find themselves in this country. He made one mistake to me. In spite of all that he didn't inculcate, he didn't inject a language amongst the people. While he seek to help them for food, clothes, and shelter, which is good. No discourse against him, no condemnation, but what is needed, you have to have a language. But through your language, then you'll be able to maintain a culture. As Dusky says, the language profoundly shapes our thoughts and ideas. Language are the expression of the thoughts and ideas that are formulated in the mind. And if I educate you, what are the thoughts and ideas you think it's going to bring out? I shut the door in your face. So when we're talking in terms of an African religion enjoying the question of social activities. We don't just sit in a church and just jump up and say, well, I love my people, oh, I love God. No, God is action. God is basically action. We can become passive if we choose to. That's our choice. But I say this to you all, the way I'm sitting here this morning, it's not a question. I am in the service of Amun. And whether you like it, you don't like it, that's what I'll do. That's what I come out to do. That's what I will follow. The path of Ammon. When the children or when the people in Egypt was dominated through the Hyksos coming into the country, take the country around the 18th century BC, they pillage and dominate the country. They cause havoc in the country, rule the country for about 200 years. Who were the people who bring liberation to the ancient Egyptian in that part? What they call it, they call it the new kingdom or somewhere? Who were the people who bring liberation to the people? It was the priest and the priestess under the guidance of the god they call Amun who stepped in and removed the foreigners, remove the conquerors from amongst them, that they've been able to the end of time having what they call the glorious moment in their civilization. And this is not about hating anybody. This is not, I'm not telling anybody to go and hate no white people. That's not what I'm talking about. That's your individual talk, choice if you want to. But I'm talking about we as a people collectively practicing a religion, the importance of your religion, what it is to give to yourself that you can give to your children that come after you. Our communities are pillaged with drugs. Our community are pillaged with crimes. Where are we getting these drugs and crime from? Because of the nasty, the dirty habits that we picked up from European culture. Culture was disseminated, broken up, and then pushed upon you something. And today we fight, the north fighting the south fighting the north. This one don't want to see this. This one is a West Indian, the next one is a. If this thought of oneness amongst us, recognizing the unity amongst us, Marcus Garvey, and Du Bois, two champions, we as Africans in the diaspora would have been a much better situation where we are today. And this is the door that shuts upon us, the education that we receive from European. What we have taken in is European culture, European habits, European values, and that's what we're functioning on, and that's the thing that is preventing us from really coming together as a one people. That's the thing that's preventing us from accepting ourselves as who we are and accepting the culture, your religion, which is most important to carry you through, give you a worldview, give you sustenance. It becomes difficult to accept it. So that woman act based upon the teachings, the education that you receive from Set. The decree, Set sent out a decree to predict the education. So she followed those thoughts and ideas that Set sent out. So she slammed the door in the face of our Set. And it's the same thing we do. We were taught that black people ain't good. You ain't good. Even in the Bible, with some scroll they take out in the Bible, shows you how they describe black people. You were never good, you would never be good amongst those who dominate you. And what is necessary, you have to forgo these thoughts and ideas and gain your own value, your own sense of value, who you are, and recognize that what is said about you is not truth. You have to rise to a higher state, and the only way I'm seeing at this point you can do that is to come back to your gods and goddesses. Come back to your own tradition, your own value, which will help you to stand better in time and space. Two, culture. Set, as the ruler of the land, created a change in the culture that was existing before he began to rule the land. The woman followed the culture without knowledge of the subliminal effect on her personality. She think everything was normal.